I want to show you how to create a faux high key bright portrait. I'm starting with an image in Lightroom. Now this image is actually slightly underexposed, but that's okay. We're going to go ahead and make this look like a high key bright image. When you're shooting and you're on location and getting the shot, you really want to make sure you get the face of a portrait exposed clear and sharp and get a good exposure on that. Now, there may be situations where the surrounding elements are bright, you get some bright highlights in that around your image. That's fine as long as the exposure on the face is good. Here, everything is fitting within the histogram. We do have some shadows that are bumped up against the left side, and we're going to need to take care of that. But you can see on the right side where most of the information is stored, we've got it pretty well exposed. And again, it's a little dim. So let's go ahead and start brightening this up in Lightroom, and then we're going to take it over to Photoshop. What I'm going to do is move the exposure over just a touch, and that you're going to see the histogram move with that. And then I'm going to add fill light. Fill light's going to help open up those shadows that are looking a little too dark. And right off the bat, you can see that we've just moved the histogram into a really good zone where basically all the pixels are within the range of the histogram. Now, over to the left with the blacks, we want to bring those in just a little bit and make sure we get some nice rich shadows. There we go. I'm going to add a little clarity, some vibrance, and some saturation. All right, so that's looking great here in Lightroom. I'm going to go ahead and open this in Photoshop. This particular image was captured with a camera that didn't have the rotation sensor in it, so I have to counter-rotate that. Now, in Photoshop, what I want to do is I want to take advantage of adjustment layers, and I'm going to create a brightness and contrast adjustment layer. Now, if you worked with Photoshop in the past, brightness and contrast was a clunky, pretty much useless tool that destroyed pixels. Well, fortunately, Photoshop has fixed their brightness contrast tool, so it works pretty well and does what you think it would do. So using this adjustment layer, I'm going to take the brightness of this image and bring it way up. Here you can see the horizon of the water is almost disappearing. And that's fine. I'm going to take the contrast down just a little bit so it softens that. Okay, now remember, we want to get the exposure in her face to look properly exposed. So what I'm going to do now is in the mask for the brightness contrast adjustment layer, I'm going to brush in black, which is going to allow this mask, it's going to basically remove this mask from the particular area that I'm painting. But before I do that, I'm going to go up to opacity and I'm going to lower that. Right now I have it at about 25%. So I'm going to do some light brushing on this. Taking the brush tool, I can hit D for default for the black and white paints, foreground and background. Hit X to bring the black to the foreground. And I'm just going to paint where I want this exposure to be just a little bit darker. And I'm going to slowly, basically I'm just click holding and dragging, letting go, click holding and dragging over the areas that I want to darken and just slightly remove this adjustment layer mask. Okay, and this is looking pretty good. I want to go back into the face and do a little more detail. And also there's a little bit of a sunburnt area here on the chest that I want to correct. So what I can do is I can hit X and it'll switch the paint from the foreground to the background. This is going to allow me to paint white or paint out those areas I don't want to include. Now looking at the face, I want to brighten the eyes up just a little bit. I'm just going to kind of move around the face and brighten up the areas that seem as if they should be just a touch brighter. And essentially, there you have it. A faux high key portrait using Lightroom and Photoshop. Now if you enjoyed this tip, please be sure to check out my 31 Days to Understanding Photoshop ebook video tutorial. And in this, there's 31 lessons that are going to give you the foundation and the confidence to use Photoshop on a daily basis. Check it out. I hope you enjoyed this tip. There are plenty more like it on my blog. Be sure to check them out. And while you're there, be sure to sign up for an online photography e-class. Together, we'll take your photography skills to the next level.